Have you ever contemplated, considered, or thought about our social dynamic, the inflation, the wars that's been progressing, the medical information or disinformation, society, who's really controlling this?
A new world order.
There are people who believe that the Illuminati run the world. They count as their members Angela Merkel, Joe Biden.
The skull and bones have sworn an oath to keep the society's business a secret.
What are secret societies?
For a long time, I've been hearing about secret societies. Some people claim they are harmful organizations, and others say they are useful to society.
There have always been secret societies to retain knowledge.
There are all sorts of secret societies. There are political ones, there are criminal ones, and indeed there are occult ones.
Not much is known about these groups, yet they all might be controlling the world from behind the scenes.
Why are you asking these things?
The Priory of Sion is a myth. One of the world's oldest and most secret societies, with leaders like Sir Isaac Newton, Da Vinci himself. The fleur-de-lis is their crest.
Number 10, unification or death, also known as the Black Hand. Number 9, the Hashashin. Number 8, Ordo Templi Orientis. Number 7, the Hermetic Order of the Golden Dawn. Number 6, the Knights Templar. Number 5, the Order of the Solar Temple. Number 4, the Bilderberg Group. Number 3, Skull and Bone. Number 2, the Illuminati.
Illuminati.
Number 1, Freemasons.
Over the next century, they smuggled it out of Europe, and they formed a new brotherhood called the Freemasons, in honor of the builders of the Great Temple.
And there you have it.
Go to a new day. I communicate. Dot dot did it. Dot dot dash.
Hold up! Wait a minute.
Hidden in plain sight.
Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening. What's in your community, locally and globally? And Vessel One, and with me, Vessel Two.
Hey, quick question.
Hidden in plain sight.
Vessel one, vessel two.
Talks about hidden in plain sight.
And with that, let's get into it.
Hold it.
Now wait.
Brothers and sisters,
do you know what time it is?
What time is it?
It's been a long time. I was giving you time to get the last one straight.
Hidden in plain sight.
And it's all about who you know.
Exactly, exactly, exactly. Yeah. Great, great. This is very, like I said, it's a very interesting topic and subject. pushing along, how would you like to do this? Would you like to just go through this form from the senior Dr. X or so?
Yeah, let's see how much we can get done.
Okay, all right.
Let's get his valued opinion out on the table, and I'm pretty sure he'll be able to put it in a more of a layman's term than we could.
Right. Okay, here we go.
We attempt to understand history without understanding secret societies. To be quite honest, you cannot talk about history and not talk about secret societies, because they dictated the moves. Well, that's why history in school is inaccurate. There should have been full courses on the movement of Freemasonry, for instance. How do you miss that and only casually mention that in history? How do you do that? I don't know how you do that. That's why I say any attempt to understand history and not understand the secret societies, I'm talking about going all the way back 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 years ago, because we just had variations of those things. And that includes Kabbalah, who many say that's where we're at, that's what we're dealing with here today in terms of this whole satanic move that's going on right in front of our faces, with the children being snatched up by these forces and used in ritual sacrifices. And it's funny, Bear, because you can literally see some forms of lineage in terms of families that have been involved in this stuff. You know, you can take the Rockefellers.
Mm-hmm.
They not royalty. They ain't never been no royalty. But they got wealthy. Okay, so they became players. They weren't born into wealth. They swindled people into wealth. Okay? All these people, the Carnegies, the Vanderbilts, we just looking at their lineage. And at the top, those lineages or bloodlines get even smaller because they wouldn't marry outside of their class. All of these things and the child ritual sacrifices go all the way back to Old Testament in the worship of Baal that we see today, right? Everywhere. They unveiled it right in front of everybody's faces. And it was amazing to me that people weren't horrified. You see, if you ain't horrified as a statue of so-called devil that never existed, but they've created one called the Baphomet, 200 years old. They created this image. Okay, to represent them. So when they unveil those statues with a little white boy, I'm sorry, a little white girl and a little black boy sitting down at the feet of this demonic structure, what the hell do you say? It ain't human. It's got a goat's head. This is, they've decided to use the evil aspect. Some of the original evil aspects. That's why we say words have meaning. I mean, I keep hearing people say that all the time. You know, you can look at it numerically, and that'll give you a meaning. But words have meaning. So, yeah, you can take this thing all the way back to before Babylon. But you'll find that it was only used by a small, very small group of people. And that's at a time when there were infinitely fewer people on the planet then than there are now. It's all relative because events transpired where then you get to Akhenaten during one of the early ancient Kemetic dynasties. Now he comes in and basically picks up where his father has been teaching him. And of course, his father can't teach him that unless his father learned from people. So there would have had to have been a group inside the priest class that were already committed to the one world, one God construct that his father would teach him on the down low. So when he gets into power, he wants to kick out the priest class. Right? So now he proclaims himself the one God, male and female, and he depicts himself as such. Now, that's the Baphomet symbol for their God construct today. The Baphomet represents the feminine and masculine energy, all in one. Right?
Right.
So, that's what LGBT represents today. That's what transhumanism represents today. That's what trannies represent today. All of it is male, female, no matter which side you're on in that stuff. So it's obvious that they're following something, right? Since they all seem to be lining up with the same stuff. Kink, filth, nasty, baby eaters. Okay, blood drinkers. Now, how I'm going to lead this out of history when that is history? We're talking the use of what we call magic today. They're just small pieces of that overall scientific system coming out of ancient Kemet. Okay, these are the things that they use to become master builders. that by definition is the ultimate in Freemasonry, the master builder. So that's why when you do the research, you find out that Freemasonry came from ancient Kemet as well. But now, them people had bloodlines. And some say them bloodlines went back to Enki, so-called fallen angels. These people creating a new system of tarot. Now, remember now, tarot, the primary cards are 22 in number, right?
Right.
And each one of them cards represent one of the books in the Old Testament.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, those same 22, because the Joker, the first card, moves all around the beginning and the end. He's the Alpha and the Omega. Right?
Yeah.
So he had the beginning and the end. But each one of those represent one of the 22 bones in your body. I'm sorry, in your face and hand. And the little white girl comes along, she creates a new tarot. She's Jewish, and she's into Satanism.
Mm-hmm.
The very things that are revealing themselves right now through, I can't even say the name, and maybe I shouldn't be able to, Balenciaga, okay, with ball at the front of the name.
Would you like to chime in, Vessel 2?
Yeah, that's interesting, Big Town. He pointed out how there is evil amongst us.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. Brought it up to modern times with the fashion, the fashion mogul company having their spell being revealed to where they're into child sacrifice and I guess pedophilia. It's sick.
Yes.
Sickening.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Let's push along. Hopefully I can get back to where I was at.
And see, Baal, that's the Old Testament name for the symbol we know as the Baphomet today. That's the symbol for that. Worked for Vatican intelligence, Malachi Martin, by his own admission, which again is the Jesuits. And now I was talking about much of. Go ahead, man.
The Jesuits, weren't they the assassins?
They were the military wing of the church.
Okay, all right.
All right, now, the Illuminati. They were taught by this Arab group or Muslim group called the Assassins.
Mm.
Okay? That's where the Illuminati originally comes from. And, of course, it was being perpetuated by Adam Weishaupt, who was actually Jewish but became a Jesuit because of the Inquisition. Okay? So he goes as a member of high standing inside the Catholic Church, and he creates the Illuminati inside the church. No, John Paul II, Drew. John Paul I was murdered on the 33rd day. That's what I think it was The Godfather 2 or 3. That's what that movie deals with. Okay, with the Masonic hits that were taking place all over the place. And what was interesting was 10 years after that, by the late 70s, the Old Testament and its connections had declared war on the Mafia. And that's why you haven't heard anything about the Mafia out of Italy since the late 1980s, early 1990s. That's when they declared war on the Mafia. And that was the beginning of the downfall of the church in this country. The Catholic Church was being exposed for all the connections that it had, particularly with the underworld. Okay? So those are just little sidebars, although they are very important things to understand. Because now the mob is basically run by Old Testament now. Because all of the main leaders that were in Italy, right, Sicily and you know, those places, their headquarters, they were basically totally removed. And it was a war. It was written all over the European press. And the mob decided to take out judges and prosecutors. And they was killing, blowing up their cars and all this kind of stuff, at least what they were capable of. At some things in The Godfather, yes, like the move with the mafia basically bailing out the Vatican. But they didn't go into the Freemason connection, which
okay.
None of that could happen without the Freemasons because they were the ones embedded in the police forces and the military through one of the higher-ranking Masonic organizations called Propaganda Dewey. Propaganda Dewey, better known as the Pt.II. You can Google all this, family. The Pt.II. When records of the Pt.II membership were revealed, it was revealed that they were very connected to the Sovereign Military Order of Malta, which, again, their symbol is that red cross. Okay? They call it the Maltese cross. And, of course, that red cross was the symbolic emblem of the Masons, okay, the so-called Knights of the Round Table, who all had that red cross on their armor. This was their symbolic reference. And, of course, they became, and even before that, they were the builders. But you can go back and look at the tales that were talked about, the Knights of Malta, or these knights during those times, in the 10th century, and you'll find that they allegedly, through their leadership, had made a pact because they had to take a vow of celibacy. They were not allowed to marry or have anything of value, but during the Crusades, they were in fact confiscating things of value, and as the story goes, they had become acquainted with let's just call it the Baphomet. These Muslims that they were fighting, who they made alliances or allegiances with, some of them. So they became Masons too. They were already Masons. They probably just didn't call themselves that. But they were the Islamic version. It said that the Masons had taken vows to become Islamic because of things that were revealed to them by these Muslims. And one of the things that they allegedly were shown was the head of John the Baptist. Okay? And that supposedly became the Baphomet. They made allegiances to the Baphomet back then, the 10th century. And the Pope, and I forget which king, King Philip, found out about the pact that they made and did a purge of them, had them all arrested, particularly the leader, Jacques de Molay, and he was subsequently beheaded on Friday the 13th. And that's where and when Friday the 13th got its notion as being, you know, a bad luck day. That's where it started, with the beheading of Jacques de Molay. Interesting is the order of the young boys in the Masonic Lodge today is called the Order of de Molay, after Jacques de Molay. So the Pope and King Philip was so pissed off that they was just arresting all of these knights. And of course, that forced the remaining ones to go up underground. And this is how, when they resurfaced through Adam Weishaupt, the founder of the Illuminati. Now, what is interesting is many of those knights were Old Testament, even though they were sworn allegiance to King Philip and the crown, because they were the ones who were the heavyweights during that time. Okay? So you can see how these people who consider themselves Old Testament have had to do what they had to do to survive until they were able to resurrect themselves and begin to thrive again. Okay? Mm-hmm. If you watch any of the old movies with depictions of gypsies, the gypsies were always assumed to be Old Testament vagabonds who could never stay in one spot, so they was always on the move, but they was always heavy into mysticism, tarot cards, etc.
Mm-hmm.
Well, many of those knights were in fact Old Testament. When they were supposed to be guarding people going back and forth to the Holy Land, Israel, back in them days, they were the guardians of Jewish pilgrims. Now, why would the church be guarding Jewish pilgrims when they would subsequently be made to convert to Catholicism? Okay, like Christopher Columbus, for example. He was a Spanish Jew. His real name was Cristobal Colon. So these people went all throughout Latin America killing people, right, in the name of the church. But they were really Jews who established an underground network all throughout Latin America with what we know today as what's called the Sephardic Jews. Okay? As opposed to the blonde-haired, blue-eyed Jews, now you got the Spanish Jews, of which Ocasio-Cortez claims to be one. That's why she said she's Jewish. But the ugly secret in Judaism is the blonde-haired, blue-eyed Jews don't necessarily connect with the Sephardic. The Ashkenazi, which is the blonde hair, blue eyes, are really prejudiced against the Sephardic because they're darker skinned. So they don't want their children, the Ashkenazi, marrying no Sephardic. Significant figures were members of it, right? And as we've established in other forums, many of these people were into the occult, and they were doing it underground because science and the church was at odds with each other. That's one of the primary precepts in this whole trilogy with the Da Vinci Code and the other two movies, all right? And all the time, they're using ancient Cometan symbology later on in the other movies, showing you that these are really ancient African concepts that have been borrowed, appropriated, some say stolen, from ancient African traditions. Okay, kind of like what I was saying earlier with Santeria, where now the roles have been reversed in the southeast of this country, where you've got ancient African traditions that have been fused with Christian traditions. One thing about history, family, particularly ancient history, is you should never be absolute about any of it, because knowledge is being brought forth on a consistent basis, on a continuous basis, that further clarifies the puzzle that is history. Okay? So when they talk, when we talked earlier about the Lion of Judah and consciousness, right, by way of Zion and New Jerusalem, America, according to the people behind the scenes who were involved in the exploitation, they said exploration, the exploitation in the so-called founding of America, referred to it as the New Jerusalem. That was the metaphysical, been a consistent thread with all of this stuff. This stuff didn't just come out of nowhere. It's been quietly nurtured by secret societies, Masonic organizations, etc. All right? The Illuminati come out the church. The Illuminati were the knowledge-based scientific wing of the church. All right? And then it moved to the universities. The church did indeed reject these ideas, but it never tried to repress femininity. On the contrary, instead of a penitent spouse, the woman chosen was the virgin mother, she who was born without sin, the great intermediary, the queen of heaven, the mother of God. Mary, mother of God, attracted such an intensive cult that sometimes she even overshadowed her divine son. Most cathedrals, built by the bishops of cities and not by the Templars, are dedicated to her, as are hymns of praise, prayers, and visions. Okay? And as a reference point, particularly in Latin America, it's Our Lady this, Our Lady that, right? Not Jesus, Our Lady. All right? So, if they were really serious about it, and again, from my readings, it was to accommodate the religions that were already there, or belief systems that were already there, that accommodated the feminine God construct along with the male God construct. But over a period of time, that was removed. Okay? They go on to say this. Catholic theology went very far and very daringly in the direction of the cult of the Great Mother, the Mother of God. The church was not free of prejudices that were common in that period. Women were sinners and foolish. But on the spiritual plane, the church behaved very respectfully toward women. There were and there are many female saints and mystics who garnered and are still garnering respect and worship. The church authorities have never said that Mary Magdalene was a whore. This is a popular conception, in fact. She continues to be considered a key and important saint who politely gave center stage to a figure more important than she. During Constantine's time, Christianity was not a religion on the rise, but a persecuted cult whose very existence was endangered. At the Council of Nicaea, it was not decided that Jesus was divine. Let me read that again. At the Council of Nicaea, it was not decided that Jesus was divine. This is already hinted at in the New Testament and has been accepted by most Christians since the beginnings of Christianity. It was decided at the council to reject the Arian position, that's the black man, according to which the father preceded the son. The results of the vote were not balanced, but were determined by a vast majority against the Arians. There was never a secret order called the Priory of Sion. The Templar order was established in 1119 in Jerusalem. It was a military order that had no esoteric or special spiritual pretension, but it got some, particularly from the Muslims. All right? They say, and with the conquest of the Holy Land by the Muslims, it devoted itself to money matters. What aroused the envy of the French was not any secret doctrine, but rather the order's enormous wealth. No, it was both, and how they came about acquiring that wealth, because they had been opened up to the use of magic. What we're dealing with today is fake feminine energy. Okay, that's why it's being propagated by lesbians. Okay, so they say, femininity was symbolized by Mary Magdalene, Jesus' spouse, and the mother of his children. Jesus was a prophet and teacher who, among other things, brought this message of yin and yang to his followers. These facts were repressed and concealed by the church establishment, especially since the days of Constantine. This pagan emperor became a Christian for political reasons, and at the Council of Nicaea, succeeded in transforming Jesus into a god and concealing Mary Magdalene. Since then, femininity has gone underground. Mary Magdalene's remains and the secret documents that tell the real story were found on the Temple Mount when Jerusalem was conquered in the First Crusade. Okay? They go on to say, in 1099, Priory of Sion was established, and the aim of this order was to keep the secret. It set up an internal military branch called the Poor Knights of Christ and of the Temple of Solomon, or the Templars, the Poor Knights of Christ and of the Temple of Solomon, that we call the Knights Templars. The order flourished until 1307, when many of its members were arrested at the initiative of the French king, Philip the Fair, and Pope Clement V. In 1312, the arrested at the initiative, or what? In 1312, the order was disbanded by the papacy, but the secret treasure was saved. It had been transferred well before then to the members of the Priory of Sion, who kept it underground and acted to plant secret hints in the culture. About the concealed truth. Among the heads of the order were Isaac Newton, a Protestant, Sandro Botticelli, a Catholic penitent, Victor Hugo, a Republican atheist, Leonardo da Vinci, and Jean Cocteau. Da Vinci's paintings are sophisticated codes. The Mona Lisa, for example, is no less than an androgynous self-portrait. An androgynous self-portrait. This is Da Vinci painting the Mona Lisa. But he paints it as himself, right? In opposite. So he paints the Mona Lisa as himself as a woman. So what was he smoking? No. He was heavily, like the other people, people of the establishment during his time, heavily involved in the occult. Because the people that are in charge today are heavily involved in the occult. Okay? That would be Kabbalah, as an example. All right? Jewish occultism. And many important people, like Oprah Winfrey, are members of the Kabbalah, practice Kabbalah. Okay? Now, they go on to say, more importantly, in the painting of the Last Supper in Milan, the secret is revealed almost entirely. Even though the ceremony that is depicted is ostensibly the moment of the establishment of the rite of the Mass and the consecration of the Grail, which the Catholic tradition identifies as the sacred chalice, there is no special chalice on the table.
We would like to thank everyone out there for tuning in again. Welcome to the new year, 2023. And we encourage you to keep listening, subscribe, like, share. And with that, any final thoughts, Russell, too?
Final thoughts. It's a new year, as you said, 2023. Hopefully this year brings everybody exactly what they deserve, good or bad, depending on what moves you made this year or last year. Please stand on your square. Pay attention to the information that we're trying to put out that we covered today, especially in regards of the secret societies, because it seems like we cannot get around them, over them, or under them. For all of you who have loved ones, make sure that they know. Until next time, peace.
Peace.